And we want all the inside story on the next season. How dark, how mean, how
that we all
dirty.
Die.
Yeah.
An asteroid, a meteor hits. And, no. As much as that I can tell you. Well, I can tell you a little bit. When we ended the season two, originally, Ivory was supposed to die. And, you know, we were thinking that that was going to happen, but the writers wrote an alternate ending, and we did one where she lives and Scab saves her. And it was a little, you know, nerve-wracking because when we wrapped the show, I had no idea which ending was going to happen and what her fate was. And it wasn't until Roland, who plays Scab, text me, and he did ADR and said, "She lives, we live," and I just screamed to the top of my lungs. I was so excited. I was jumping up and down, and so leading into this season, I really didn't know what to expect because things can change like that, and what I can tell you is the sisterhood is stronger and better than ever, and we are taking over. And that's basically all I can say about that.
when you find there's two endings, what's going through your mind and heart? And
well, you know what? In this business, and what I'm so happy that I get to do what I do. And you know that a story has to live the way the story has to live. And it twists and it turns and it does all kinds of things. And you just have to be game for that when you sign on to do something like this. So, you know, at first, I thought it was just going to be, you know, a small, maybe two-day thing, you know. And then it grew and grew and grew and grew from there, yeah. And it just goes to show, you know, you never know where life or any of that type of stuff is going to take you. And so here I am, you know, 2 years back now. And I remember prepping for this audition and, you know, getting so stoked that I was going to have an opportunity to, you know, flex my acting muscles a little bit. And now I blink and I'm sitting at this table with all of you and I'm at Comic-Con and it's just like, it's, my mind is just, hey, turn it.
Do you feel like any pressure to be like part of like the Van Helsing like legend as you know for your character? Like, do you feel any pressure as an actress to be a part of like the history and everything?
That's a good question. Gosh, when as a woman do you not feel pressure? But I feel pressure in the sense that it has a big fan base and it has a lot of people that have grown up with comics and the story, and I want to honor that and I want to make sure that, you know, I'm staying true, like putting in my creative input into it too, yet still respecting, you know, the laws of vampireness, you know? Because, you know, like, this is a show I would watch if I wasn't on the show, because I love that type of stuff. I mean, sci-fi is where you have no rules, and you can do whatever and anything can go, and I just wish real life was like here, just more open-mindedness, I guess, so that answered your question. I think I just went on a whole other rant there, but
yeah. We got it.
You mentioned in the panel that the sisterhood is expanding, and obviously we can't have spoilers about how that is so.
Yeah.
But if you could build your sisterhood, like if you had your own fanfic to write to build your sisterhood, who would be included?
Well, all of you.
Thank you.
She would be included. I think I would want to work with anybody that is open to change and wants that. It's funny how we play vampires, and it's funny how, you know, it's this human versus vampire. When, you know, last season when Scab saved me. Now you find the humans in the show aren't even that loyal to each other. And I think with Ivory and her experiences in season two, you see that she was burnt at the stake, that, you know, humans, again, betrayed her. They burnt her, they killed her because she believed in one thing and not their thing. And she wouldn't conform. And that let her, obviously let her down. She died. And then here comes Scab, a vampire. The evil, the villain, the, you know, the underdog. He's the lowest of the vampires, and he saves her. And in that, loyalty comes. And I think that surprised her more than anything. And so I think what she would want for anyone to be a part of his sisterhood is that, is loyalty and wanting to actually have someone's back, which, you know, sadly, sometimes in this day and age, it feels like that doesn't really even exist. So, with that, again, I feel like I keep going on these, like...
Do you do your own stunts? You seem very athletic already, so do you do your own stunts?
Actually, I do. I do, and for this show, I do, yes. Kamani Smith, who is our stunt coordinator, he's freaking fantastic. It's also a little hard to double me. I'm a very tall person. But and I love physicality like that. I do a lot of motion capture and things like that, too. So I am very physical. And so when I read that there was going to be some fight scenes, you know, I said to him, like, I'm really game. Like, as long as you don't light me on fire... As long as I don't, like, ratchet through anything, I'm going to do it. And thankfully, him and the team worked with me, and we just fired along. So I got to do, yeah, I get to do all my fighting stuff. So, yeah, I mean, yeah, it's the best part, for sure.